Hello, I'm Joe Szabo, Administrator of the Federal Railroad Administration. July 6th marks a significant tragedy in North America when an unsecured crude oil train derailed in the town of Lac-Mégantic in the province of Quebec. 47 people died. As a fifth-generation railroader and former mayor of a railroad town, my heartfelt sympathies go out to the families and community of Lac-Mégantic, all whose lives are forever changed. Over the last year, this tragedy has been a constant reminder of what could have happened elsewhere, and that's why we've been doing everything possible to minimize risk, increase redundancies in our safety protocols, and prevent any single point of failure. Every day, we're working to make sure that an incident like that in Lac-Mégantic never occurs again. Safety is our top priority at FRA, and we can never rest in our goal of driving continuous safety improvement. The Department of Transportation, through the FRA and our sister agency, the Pipelines and Hazardous Materials Safety Administration, has taken an expansive approach to secure the short-term and long-term safety of the public. Over the last year, we've issued a series of emergency orders, safety advisories, and alerts. We launched Operation Classification to ensure that shippers and carriers in North Dakota's Bakken oil region fully comply with all regulations for sampling, testing, and classification of shipments, and we're advancing a regulatory action on train securement and train crew size. Working with the industry, we forged an agreement to ensure the safest routes are being used for crude oil movements, track and equipment inspections are being increased, speeds are being reduced, braking protocols enhanced, and training increased for emergency first responders. We mandated that emergency responders be given advance information about the frequency and routing of crude oil trains. And we're moving forward with a comprehensive rulemaking, including new design specifications for tank cars, a rule that we're committed to put on the street for public comment this year. Along with the Pipeline and Hazardous Materials Safety Administration, we will continue to move aggressively. So stay informed and follow our progress at our homepage and follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Thanks for listening.